Hello everybody, how y'all doing today? I know I look bad, but somebody who does a lot of work always looks bad. I'm Grandpa Cotton, and today I want to talk to y'all about my 2002 Chevy Suburban. Well, actually, it's my wife's Chevy Suburban. We got this thing in about 2003. She's had it ever since. It has a 5.3 liter Vortec engine in it. Never had any major problems out of this vehicle. It's been a good one. It's got 360 something thousand miles on it, and it's her everyday driver back and forth to the hospital. Probably need a new one, but ain't nothing wrong with this one. It just come back from Gatlinburg, Tennessee. But what I want to talk to y'all about is I recently had some problems with this thing. I took this vehicle to Baker Transmission about 6 years ago out in 8 Mile, Alabama. And I went over there because transmission was giving me problems. Well, he told me that the transmission was full of water and it was due to a coolant leak inside the radiator. So I had to have a transmission put in this vehicle and a radiator. Okay, this is going to be the fun part of it. Here several weeks ago, we drove this thing up to Gatlinburg, Tennessee. Let me go back to Baker's Transmission. The old man that owns the place over there has his son that worked for him who stayed in and out of trouble all the time. He's the one who worked on the truck. They put a transmission in this thing. Me and my wife got ready to go on a trip. Transmission started slipping. So that's after about a week of having it in here. So I took it back over there to them and they said that was natural. I said, no, that ain't natural. So anyhow, after arguing with them and threatening them and telling them I'm gonna sue them, they finally put another transmission in the vehicle. Okay. Everything's been good since then. But I won't ever suggest anybody going to Baker's Transmission over there because I'm fixing to tell you why. Well, on this vehicle right here, we've had problems with every time we put it in gear, it takes off. It goes up to about 2200 RPM. And it does it sometimes, sometimes it don't do it. Sometimes it only does it when it's cold. Sometimes it does it when you're in traffic and you need to put on the brakes and burn the brakes off from it. Rough idle on the crank up in the mornings. After it warms up, appears to run fine, but it throttles up. Okay, as a backyard mechanic I've been for over 50 years, I changed the throttle body out, every electrical component on the throttle body. I changed the mass airflow sensor out and all the rest of it, the other one that's on there. Blowed all the lines, cleared the throat on it, changed the EGR valve, plugs, wires. Still couldn't get this high idle out of it. There's not a lot on the internet about a high idle vehicle. Like I say, this is the 5.3 Vortec. But when you put this sucker in gear, she takes off. And if you boys are out there having this trouble and you cannot figure out what the problem is, you've changed everything on the vehicle, I'm going to tell you what it is. You can take it to the bank that this is the problem. It's the intake manifold gaskets. When they get bad and it starts sucking air, it causes it to miss when it's cranked up in the morning when it's cold. It causes it to have a high idle, or it causes it not to idle at all. It just depends on the symptoms on it. But y'all remember, you got this from Grandpa Cotton because there's nobody else out there got it on there. If you got a high idle problem with your Chevy, it's the intake manifold gaskets. Don't cost nothing to change it out much. It's a pain in the butt to change it out, but it don't cost much. Let's go back to Baker Transmission over there in 8 Mile. Now, we got back off our Tennessee trip. This thing was leaking water out of there. Had a leak on the water pump, had a leak in the front of this radiator. I don't know how it got in there or what happened to it, or maybe it's because it's got 300 and something thousand miles on it. But the story is, this radiator is supposed to have been new about 5-6 years ago. Okay, let's get back to the radiator. I ordered a radiator from Dixie Radiators out of U.S. Come out, I think. Hell, I don't know where to come out of. Anyhow, we ordered it. Good radiator. People was real nice about fitting it up for them. It's DRAD Radiators is who it is. They sent me the radiator, and I ordered the water pump. Because you know, y'all all know you can get parts cheaper online than you can to go down to your local auto parts. So, I ordered this radiator. I changed the air intake manifold yesterday. Put everything back together on the truck, fired it up, oh, she run, okay. I got to put everything back together. I got to put the fan on, fan shrouds, got to put the radiator in. So I go to put my radiator in. Radiator goes right in, bolts up fine, everything's wonderful. Go to hook my transmission lines up, and guess what? It's the wrong radiator, I thought. So I'm thinking, now how in the world these idiots send me the wrong radiator? Well, they didn't send me the wrong radiator. The idiots over there at Baker Transmission, where I took my truck to have a transmission put in it and a new radiator. And after two transmissions, I finally got one that actually worked for a while. The radiator they put in my truck was out of a 90s model vehicle. And it was probably a used radiator because it had screw-in lines on it. So the transmission had to be out of a... Me and the girl at the auto parts just throwed it out there. This is an 02, and everybody knows from a 2000 to a 2006, all the parts are on the same on the Tahoe and on the Suburban, as well as the Silverado. All the parts are the same. Everything fits. Okay? We started looking up vehicles to find out which one's got the right radiator hose. Okay, it shouldn't have no problem getting the radiator hoses and getting the transmission lines to screw into the radiator. But we got all the way down to a 1997 Chevy Silverado. The transmission in this truck come out of a 1997, and the radiator come out of a 1997. That's why it had different lines on it. So, to remedy the fix, cut the lines on the end, went down to the auto parts, bought one single line, cut the ends off of it, put the snap ends on it, put it back together. Anyhow, the problem's fixed on the truck. It idles beautifully, it cranks beautifully, it runs good, runs like a new one. But let me tell you, people, and I'm saying this from the bottom of my heart, don't y'all ever take your vehicle to Baker Transmission in 8 Mile. If you do, they're going to screw you. I don't know if the old man's still alive or dead. This is a free country and freedom of speech. But that really pissed me off today to find out that I had to re-rig a radiator that's supposed to have clip-in lines for the transmission. But I'm done for now. I want all y'all to have a great year. I'm down with heart failure, so I don't know how long I'm going to live. I hope I live another 20 years. Rule of thumb is, bad idle, taking off when you put it in gear, high RPMs or low RPMs. It's the intake manifold. Change it, you won't have no more problems, and you'll save yourself a lot of money if you do it yourself. The parts to do that job was $43.35 to put new gaskets on it. And about 2 hours worth of time. But that's all from Grandpa Cotton. And y'all remember to all y'all do it yourself. That was the problem with the high aisle, taking off when you put it in gear. And y'all change it out. And all y'all have a great day. Grandpa Cotton, talk to y'all later.